And now we're going to learn how to make debits and credits with inventory transactions. And this video, we will specifically learn about the perpetual inventory system. We have already learned how to record an income from a service. It's just one T account that represents the total money that came in from what we earned. In previous cases, it was just one number, the service fee, and it represented the price of the service. So you previously made a credit to this income account for exactly what the customer gave you. However, when we have merchandise that we're selling, we still have an income account that represents the total money that came in from the customer for merchandise sales. But in a case of a merchandise company, we're not dealing with one number in the income section. We're really dealing with three numbers. The sales price of the merchandise, which will get recorded as a credit to this income account, the same way the income from a service got recorded to the service income account. But with merchandise, we also have to consider how much did the merchandise cost you when you bought it. Because the difference between the price that you record as income and the cost that you pay for the merchandise will be your profit. Now, the most important words in this video are the words cost and the words price. And you have to make sure you know the difference between the word cost and the word price. Cost means the amount that we paid to purchase the merchandise from the vendor. But for that very same merchandise, the word price means the amount we received from the customer when selling the merchandise. And of course, the difference is your profit. Price minus cost equals profit, and we all know that, but only if the goods are sold. So we therefore have to clarify our definition. We should really say the price of the goods that were sold minus the purchase cost of the goods that were sold is what really equals our profit. The price of the goods that are sold is the value that the customer gives us. The cost of the goods that are sold is the value of what we gave to the customer. It's what we paid for the goods that went out. The word perpetual means continuously changing. That means if we're using the perpetual inventory method to record the sale, the account inventory asset changes after each transaction. That means it changes after we buy the merchandise, and it also changes after we sell the merchandise. Now, of course, in the top right here, we have our sales income account. This is very similar to the service income account that we were using in previous videos. You record a credit for what the customer gives you, because that's the income that you earned. So previously we made a credit for the price of the service when the customer paid us, or when we earned the service income. So now when we deliver the goods, we make a credit to sales income for the price of the goods that are sold, because that's the income that we earned, and that's a T account just like service income. However, the interesting stuff happens down here in the cost of goods sold account. This is not technically an expense, even though it behaves like an expense, and even though it has the same effect on income. It would go in the income section as a contra income account, not an expense account, because it's part of the income cycle. You have to buy, then sell. Then you can subtract your expenses to find your net income. So that explains a little bit about this new account in the bottom right cost of goods sold. And now let's see how to use these accounts when we purchase and sell merchandise. First, let's give cash a beginning balance. That's not a transaction. We're just pretending that we're starting off with $10,000 cash. Now here's our first transaction. Paid $300 to purchase merchandise. Well, we know if we pay, cash is minus cash is credit. And just like purchasing any other asset, exactly what we paid for the asset becomes a debit to that asset for that date. So this purchase transaction is no different than the ones we've learned before when we purchased other assets. But the interesting part comes here. When we sell with Perpetual, we record it twice, once for the cost and once for the price. Now that's a lovely little rhyme, so let's say it again. When we sell with Perpetual, we record it twice, once for the cost and once for the price. Let's take a look at an example. Let's imagine on January 8, we sold the specific merchandise that we purchased on January 1, but we sold them for $1,200. So you can see this is the merchandise that we purchased back on January 1. This is the merchandise sitting here waiting to be sold. Now, if we sold it for $1,200, it means that the customer gave us $1,200, and it also means we've earned $1,200 worth of income for selling the merchandise. So what would be the debits and the credits? Well, if we've earned $1,200 worth of income for sales, and we know that income is credit, on January 8th, we would have to credit the sales income account for the $1,200 that we earned. On the other hand, the customer gave us $1,200, so we have no choice but to debit cash on January 8th for the $1,200. So this first debit and credit looks just like it looked when we sold the service, credit the income and debit the cash. However, there is now an extra step for this same January 8th sale. For this January 8th sale, we also have to credit inventory because this $300 of inventory is no longer here. It went out. So we have to remove it from inventory by making a credit of $300. So then what would we debit $300? And obviously, the answer is cost of goods sold. Credit inventory for the merchandise that went out and debit cost of goods sold for the purchase cost of the specific merchandise that we gave to the customer. Can you guess the profit from this particular sale? Of course, the profit is $900. Anybody could figure that out because it was only one sale. Watch another one. Let's imagine on January 20, we purchased $500 more of inventory. Again, that's the easy one. We have $500 more of this asset, and on the other hand, we have $500 less of cash. So we know purchasing under the Perpetual system is very easy. Debit the inventory that you got and credit the cash. Now again, the interesting part is when you actually sell. Let's imagine on January 31, we sold the specific merchandise that we previously purchased on January 20, and we sold it for $3,300. Well, here's the merchandise that we purchased back on January 20, so we know that has to come out of inventory. But what should we do first? Well, we've actually earned $3,300 by receiving that from the customer for giving them the merchandise. So always income is credit for what we earned. And if the customer gave us $3,300 in cash, we have to debit cash. So the debit and the credit for the price of the January 31 sale is credit sales income and debit cash. But we're not finished. This specific $500 of inventory went out on January 31. So we credit inventory $500. Then what do we debit $500? Well, $500 was the purchase cost of the goods that we gave the customer on January 31, the specific goods. So here we have the debit and the credit for the cost. So we have four accounts changing when we make a sale. Credit sales income and debit cash for the price and the income we earned. Credit inventory for the cost of the goods that are sold. And debit cost of goods sold. Now, obviously, at the end of the month or the end of the period, we would get the total of the sales income and the total of the cost of goods sold, and we would eventually put them together to find the profit from our merchandise operation. In this case, the profit is $3,700. But when you're an accountant, you're not finished when you calculate the profit. The profit is the result of the income section of our operation. We then have to subtract out all the other expenses that we learned about in previous videos to get the final number, the net income. In fact, sales income and cost of goods sold are together in the income section of the income statement, and the expenses are at the bottom. They're both in the income section because both buying and selling are part of the revenue cycle. And if you have a merchandise business, the gross profit is the result of the income section. You then simply record all your other expenses and subtract them the way you did when you had a service business to find your final net income.